Everybody at Mech Sportstar is mourning another fatal crash and die of the Toronto Maple Leafs as they continue their tradition of choking, cacking, and fucking dying in the first fucking round, where they had the team on the ropes. They had the team last year on the ropes. They had the Boston Bruins on the ropes. And what do? Because they're good people and they want to win the Miss Congeniality Award, they let them back in the fucking game and then they get beat. So I don't know about you guys. I have Bill Waters and Eric Cohen on the phone. I couldn't watch the game anymore, so I shut it off. There was half a period left in the third, and I said, fuck it. I have enough stress in my fucking life as a human being with my own demons than to deal with a bunch of fucking underperforming millionaires.
Yeah, it was depressing. It was pathetic. There's so much blame to go around. You know, you're up 3-1 in this series, and the amount of mistakes that this team made.
3-1 with a team that barely made it into the fucking playoffs.
Yeah, no, Montreal was a very average to below average team. Yes, they have.
But I told you guys, I told Phil, who was quite surprised when we told him Carey Price was playing the playoffs, right? I told you guys that Carey Price is a Leaf killer.
Yeah, you know
he's a killer, Frank. Yeah. He beat Pittsburgh.
Yep.
This is his second beating in 2 years.
Mm-hmm. I'm just telling you that Carey Price, for me, I rank him top five, sometimes top three goalies in the world. And Carey Price was absolutely brilliant in beating the Toronto Maple Leafs at their own fucking game. And the rumor on the street, Bill, I know you're very well connected. I have some friends, and I've been told that there's going to be a major shuffle. Coaching staff, gone. Shanahan, gone.
Well, I haven't, Frank, and I only heard the story when Shanahan was sent to Phoenix to fire Mike
Babcock,
the head coach, and the director.
I've been told by a reliable source the only one that might survive is Dubas.
Not a fucking chance.
That's what I was told.
Not a chance, no.
Yeah, well, if it was up to me, I would clean up shop.
Yeah, no. If Brendan goes, they all go. That's for sure.
Yeah, Dubas is
a
champion.
Well, I heard from a reliable source that the board has an affinity and an affection for Dubas.
Well, they could, but they better check it. Dubas,
no, I'm not arguing with you. I'm on your side. I'm just telling you what I heard.
Yeah, well,
I'm not on the side. I'm not going to get defensive for Dubas. I'm just telling you that I've heard that the heads will roll and he might be the one that will be saved.
Well, who knows, eh, Frank? You're probably right. I think there has to be a serious reshuffling in order to create a new work atmosphere at Maple Leaf Gardens.
You need a new mandate. I mean, this mandate failed. End of story.
Yeah.
You need a new fucking mandate. Last year, the Toronto Maple Leafs got outcoached, and this year they got outcoached. And when you get outcoached, you get outplayed. Oh. I understand that people like to blame the players, but the players are the Ferrari, and the Ferrari is only as good as the driver. And the coach is the fucking driver, and he's got to be the one who's got to fuck around with the lines, right? Foligno, unfortunately, was a bust for any contribution to the playoffs.
He was hurt, and he didn't do your right.
I'm just telling you, he was a bust. I'm not going to try to make excuses for him, but Foligno did not work out for them, right?
No, he basically was playing on the fourth.
He was invisible.
And contributed nothing.
Nothing. And Marner, what's Marner, $8 million a year? $10 million a year?
$11 million, that's a big problem.
10 or 11.
$11 million a year. He played no better than a $700,000 player. I would say, maybe you guys could tell me to fuck off on the phone, I would say Spets at 700 grand outplayed, outshone Marner in the playoffs.
Well, there's no doubt.
I would say you're right.
Four goals. Marner hasn't scored a playoff goal in 18 games.
That's all I'm saying, okay?
Yeah.
So like, where's your fucking value now?
Marner was a complete bust.
I know Phil's going to be livid because his team choked and cacked in the first fucking round, too.
Isn't Phil a Lightning fan?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The Lightning have been pushed out in the first round, have they not?
Have, in the past, but this year they've got game two against Carolina. They're up 1-0. They beat Florida in the first round this year.
They beat Florida.
But I'm saying they're a team that's cacked in the first round, too.
They have in the past, yeah.
In the past, as a fucking team that was in first place in the division or close to first place the whole fucking year.
Well, I'll tell you, in the last 10 years, the biggest upset in the NHL in the first round was when Columbus beat Tampa a few years ago in the sweep. The second biggest upset was Montreal beating Toronto this year. So, yeah, you know what? He'll be able to relate. The difference is Tampa followed up with their disappointment by winning the Cup the following year.
Listen, I'm not going to defend the Toronto Maple Leafs, but Tampa, for I think 3 years in a row, stellar team, they fucked up.
Yeah, they had.
But with a stellar team for 3 years in a row, they were beaten in the first round. So they had a really tough 3 years.
Yep.
Yeah, they were underachievers for 2 years before they won the Cup. No question, Frank.
Yep. But the difference is, Frank, the Leafs haven't won a playoff series since 2004. This is the fifth straight year that they've lost a winner-go-home game in the playoffs in the first round.
I understand that that happens. I understand that that's what the playoffs are, right? You know, sometimes the last seed beats the first seed. I understand all of that. What the fuck I don't understand is when you have a stranglehold on somebody and you got them down 3-1, where do you fucking go for the other fucking 4 games? Do you go for the next 4 games?
Yeah, well, listen, so the Leafs are up 3-1, and then game 5, Sandin has 2 bad turnovers, results in 2 goals. The Leafs have a big comeback. They tie it up, 3 straight goals, go to overtime. A minute in, Galchenyuk with an awful turnover, results in a 2-on-0 goal.
Yeah, but that's where your goaltending comes in.
Afterwards.
Or a guy like Carey Price Vasilevskiy, that's where your big goalie makes that big fucking stop. Do you understand?
Well, I don't know. I don't know what Campbell could have done that 2-on-0. That was tough.
I'm just telling you that that's where the change comes.
Right.
I'm just telling you that the Leafs last night, you know, got outplayed by one fucking player.
Yeah.
Carey Price.
Yeah. He was good.
He was spectacular. And I've had enough. I'm not gonna let them do this to me anymore. And Leaf Nation, you know, we'll come back again next year, like, you know, in a destructive relationship where they get abused and then they rationalize, maybe it's my fault. Maybe I'm the one upsetting the cart. Well, so I'm telling you right now, I heard from very, very, you know, people that have given me always good intel that it's very, very, everybody's getting a new job.
Yeah, I'm hopeful, but I'm not surprised at that. You know, Frank, you're a goalie. You know when you're hot what they do to you. They start putting people in front of the net, and they start making it tough for the goalie. Did you see anybody touch Price?
No.
They weren't even close to getting in front of the net. It was pathetic how badly coached they were. I was just fuming. And then they go for a period and a half without putting Nylander up on the first line. For Christ's sakes, first goal wins. Everybody knows that.
Yep.
Listen, I was very impressed with Nylander's performance, right, this year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep.
I thought he was by far one of the best. Him and Austin Matthews were the team.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you guys this. I love Jason Spezza.
Spezza was great.
He was worth
the
dollar amount that they paid him.
Yep, absolutely.
They paid him minimum $785 or something.
Yeah, but he's playing because he loves the game, right?
Yeah.
At least put him on waivers. He said, I'm not playing anywhere else. He only wants to play here, so.
Yeah, but he, what I'm trying to tell you, He's playing for the love of the game, just like Jagr did at the end of his career.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So
and he's playing damn well, Frank. You know, he's got his legs. He's got his feel.
I remember, and I love Kurt Muller, don't get me wrong, I love him. But I remember Kurt Muller coming to Toronto his first year when you guys signed him, and I said to myself, what the fuck are they thinking? He lost his legs.
Yeah.
He's lost out there, right? And I remember the last 2 years of Ty Domi's career in Toronto, he looked like a fish out of water. You know what I'm saying to you?
Oh, yeah, where'd your legs go? You're gone.
Yeah, but you could see it. It's a, you're like a fucking rooster on a fucking barn. The whole game flies you by, and then you turn that way. And then you can't keep up.
No.
And I'm telling you right now, Spezza and Patrick Marleau did not lose a step.
No.
Am I right, Bill, or am I saying bullshit right now?
No, you're absolutely right. And the guy, Dominic Moore, said, I can't understand why they don't put Spets up on the second line. He's their second, but, you know, he is their second best centerman. And this is all stuff that the coach didn't do. And, you know, when the TV commentator is pointing it out to you, you know that it's obvious. But
I'm just telling you, I don't give a fuck if you're a Leaf fan or not. Last night, Montreal did not play better than the Leafs. And the Leafs lost!
Yeah. Frank, you're absolutely right. And if you have a team that plays the style that Montreal has and they beat you three in a row, that means you did not work a fucking dime. You mm-hmm. just went out there and thought you could take it from them. You didn't go to them and get it. They were awful. The Leafs didn't look like a very good team.
They didn't look like the fucking team that finished in first place in their division.
No.